Hey, boxing fans, welcome to another edition of Boxing Gorilla. I'm your host, Don Omega, Iron Truth with me, coming at you from School Desk. And today we're talking Manny Pacquiao versus Eric Morales. Manny Pacquiao destroyed Eric Morales in 3 rounds. That's all it took. He knocked Morales down in the 2nd round. Morales clearly frustrated from that point on and mentally beaten at that point, I think. It was the best 3-round fight I've ever seen.
Yeah.
But 3rd round, Morales got knocked down 2 more times.
Just Pacquiao is just too much for Morales and just too much for anybody right now at that division, it looks like.
Morales basically conceded, didn't even try to get up, really. He just sat there almost in shock, very similar to the Tyson Williams fight. He could have gotten up, but because he was clearly conscious, he just looked over like, I guess that's it. So much for that.
I don't know if he could have gotten up, but anyway, he definitely had a confused look on his face.
I don't know if it would have done any good.
No, it would not have done any good.
Probably what would have happened, he would have gotten up and just taken more of a beating.
And then it would have been stopped.
Waved off.
Yeah. But
so, anyway. Amazing fight. Could not believe three rounds.
And I was wrong by far, of course. I picked Morales to beat Pacquiao.
I was wrong by pretty far too. I was wrong by
the round. Yeah.
By the round.
But Pacquiao just destroyed him. He's a great, great fighter.
This solidifies it. Yeah, I mean, it already had been.
But he knocked him out once before this.
This even for 3 rounds for the trilogy.
Eric Morales' only 5 knockdowns have all come against Manny Pacquiao. So, in 2 fights.
That says a lot about Manny Pacquiao.
And his power. And
people will say that Morales was too old and stuff like Morales, people trying to make excuses. He's 29.
Yeah.
And yeah, he started when he was 15, but Pacquiao started when he was 16. Yeah. And Pacquiao started at a much lower weight, 106 pounds.
Yes, which is amazing how much
Morales is a naturally bigger guy.
Yeah. And
Pacquiao is naturally stronger.
And the fact is, Morales never, even in his very best years, had that kind of speed at all. So I still think it probably might have been the same result. Maybe a later round, of course, but other than that, doesn't look like it would have been much difference.
Now, Morales really has to seriously consider retirement because he's not the type of fighter that should be fighting just crap fights just to be fighting. If he has 1 more farewell fight or something, that'd be fine. Nothing wrong with that. But he doesn't need to become one of these fighters that a gatekeeper or anything, and I don't expect to see that.
No, he should retire before that, definitely. And he doesn't need the money, so.
He's had a great long career.
Yeah. And that's a lot of great fights, definitely.
I say, maybe take an entire year off.
That'll take 2 or 3 off. He would still only be 32, 33.
If he takes a year off and then gets just 1 more farewell fight, just to have a win, go away with a win, I think that would be a respectable thing. That would be great. He said he wants his last fight in Tijuana.
His hometown.
I can understand why he'd want that, but I don't know. I think it'd be better just to have it in Los Angeles or something.
Just to have
more people there.
Yeah, of course. Right. And hopefully they don't go and put it on pay-per-view, definitely.
Yeah, hopefully not.
Which I can't really see them doing that, but I could see Aaron trying it.
I could see them doing that.
But hopefully not. But anyway, that'll probably be a while before that would happen anyway.
Anyhow, congratulations, Manny Pacquiao. Only great things to come from here.
Still only, 27, 28 years old? So.
Yep.
He's got a very long future ahead of him.
27 at this point.
Unbelievable. So.
Yep, also on this undercard of this spectacular, unbelievable match there, we had Ricardo Torres get a split decision win over mighty Mike Arnudas. And one of the scores was 116-111, which I disagree with that score, but I don't really.
I haven't scored the fight round by round.
It was actually a very close fight, and actually, overall, I would even have to say I thought Arnudas did enough to win the fight.
Yeah.
But
he did knock him down. once.
He knocked him down.
Looked like he was going to get him out, actually.
And he did not press. He pressed for very briefly, and then just didn't. He never pressed him again for the rest of the fight. And he looked content to just take Torres the distance, and that's what happened.
He's very lucky he pulled out against Vivian Harris.
Yep, that's definitely sure. Lucky he pulled out against Vivian Harris. That turned out to be a great, although cowardly, move.
Yeah. Smart move for him, I guess you could call it.
I guess, I don't know. Is it better to lose to Torres or Vivian Harris?
Well, definitely better to lose to Vivian Harris. It's a much better opponent, but he loses in a much worse way, obviously.
So. Yep, so just whatever you prefer on losses. And also, speaking of questionable decisions, this one was a downright robbery.
Yeah,
Brian Valoria lost the majority, or he didn't lose,
draw.
It was a majority draw.
A draw, yeah.
But no judge had it for him. He clearly won.
Yes, absolutely.
Now, I'll say this, it was a much closer fight than it should have been. I did have it 8-4 for Brian Valoria, so you take 2 points away for the 2 knockdowns.
That's 116 to 110.
And that's no, it's nowhere close.
Yeah. Even if you had it an even fight, six rounds to six.
Which I really don't see how you could possibly have an even fight, but if you somehow did.
Yeah, boy, it still wins by
2 points.
And say you even count only one of the knockdowns, since the first one was pretty questionable.
Yep.
So count the one knockdown. He wins by a point. There's just no way that he didn't win that fight.
Absolutely.
So.
It was disgusting, that victory, or that draw, rather.
So twice now in a row he's...
Tainted an otherwise good card, I guess. Well, this other match kind of tainted it too. Juan Salgado got a 6-round unanimous decision over Licona, and... Salgado undefeated and just very, very average looking, slow.
Nothing special at all.
He was accurate with his punches, but he was slow. And I don't see him doing anything really, except getting knocked out eventually. But
and off TV, we had a fight also.
Much better fighter.
Yeah, definitely.
Much better fight. Marcus Rosen won a TKO.
Yeah, the 2004 Olympian fought
four
a
rounds.
Four rounder, and I think the guy quit on
Still, he didn't come out for the
fortunately, fight. We did not see it. They should have replaced that with that Salgado fight, definitely. So
absolutely.
Could have been a good four-fight card. So,
yeah, but anyway. I guess they didn't want to do that. So anyhow, that card, great card, definitely worth the money.
Yeah.
For the main event alone.
Yeah.
Even though it was only 3 rounds.
Right, 3 rounds.
That was a very satisfying 3 rounds. I know after the 2 rounds, I was like, man, I've already gotten my money's worth.
Absolutely.
And the third round, wow.
Great fight.
Also, over the weekend and week, we're just going over these other results since the last show. Rusman Chagayev beat John Ruiz. Ruiz actually not complaining this time, actually. Agrees with it, and Chagayev gets the shot at Nikolai Valiev. He beat Ruiz in a unanimous decision, and now he fights Nikolai Valiev.
We didn't see this fight either.
Thank God.
Thankfully, so no links, please.
We don't need them for this. If you send them, we'll download them.
Yeah.
We don't know when we'll get to watch it.
It'll be a while, probably. But
Alexander Dimitrenko, whatever this fact's name is, he won a unanimous decision also. He's now 24-0. Time to fight some 1 pound.
Yeah. Ruiz, he's probably pretty much done now, actually.
I hope so. After
I don't know what he can possibly do now. I mean,
We can hope, but I don't want to see him again. I never do.
I only want to see him against people I'd want to be beating him. That would be it.
I'd never
to see him. So... Anyway.
And I'd be willing to not take my chances, because you never know with Ruiz.
Yeah, he did beat Rahman somehow.
And you just never know what kind of crap wound up happening on the scorecards. So.
Absolutely. Anyway.
Or if someone will mysteriously test positive for steroids against him.
He'll get his title back somehow. Anyway.
That's enough.
Goodbye, Ruiz.